Okay, we just coming back from collecting this sugarcane bagasse from the street vendor who normally sell the coconut water and also this sugarcane juice. So this is basically our sugarcane bagasse. You can see the texture of the raw sugarcane bagasse. So they press it to get the juice. And now what we did now is we just want to what we call to sort of like dry the stuff before we can crush it. Okay, today we got only a little. It's okay, actually we have a lot, we already crushed a lot, but this just to for our backup lah. Okay, so this is sugarcane bagasse, and after we dry it, maybe one day we will sort of like crush this stuff. Okay, so let's see closely. So that's the thing. Okay. Okay, we done organizing everything inside this small dryer because we have just a few of the thing. Then I think it's okay. That's why this dryer is not filled up. So the drying might be better lah because there are not much here. So the speed of drying become better. But we wait for one day as usual. It's already one day since we put our sugarcane bagasse inside this dryer, so let's check it out. So because there are only few of them, so hopefully the drying happen more efficiently lah. So as you can see here, it's quite snappy, okay, meaning that the drying, the sugarcane bagasse is dried fully, okay, everything is good here. So now we will store this into this container before we can crush it. And we also get ready with this, what is this? This is silica gel, so that to prevent some moisture to creep in lah. This is air tight container. So we put them for a while in order to, what I call, before we can crush it later on. Last one here. Okay, and then we put some maybe two of silica gel in this thing, and then we close it. And next day we will crush this sample. Okay, so today we will crush our sugarcane bagasse sample, which we already dried and put inside this sealed container for about 2 days. So we put our silica gel, and after 2 days, we hope that it's still dry. And even if there is any air creeping into this container, hopefully the amount is not too much to the point that this left not brittle anymore. So let's check it. So we open the stuff. Okay, so let's check the sample. So let's snap it. Okay, so the sound is still good, mean that it's brittle. More brittle, better for that. But one thing about this sample, the sugarcane bagasse sample, some part is quite long, so we afraid to put the entire part, long part, into this what I call crusher, because we afraid that it will entangle with the blade there. So I think better if we can crush this into half like that, make it like a small sample, and I think that's much be better lah, more efficient for the crusher lah, preventing any entanglement happen. So we have just a little today, just a little there, so hopefully we can finish in less than 10 minutes. So let's crush this stuff. Okay, so that is the sound of crush sugarcane bagasse, and let's see the flow rate. So it's very fast thanks to our brittle sample, so the rate is quite fast there. And let's see the what we call the texture of our crushed sugarcane bagasse sample. So this is the texture, yeah. Okay. So let's continue. We done with crushing our sugarcane bagasse sample. It just take about like 5 minutes only to crush everything. It's quite fast. It's very fast actually, because it's brittle and also the blade doesn't have any problem to crush this stuff. Okay. So we got this much of our sample. Not sure how much this, but I think less than around 5 liter like that. So this the texture, and that's it.